Welcome back to my channel. It is 2019, okay? And I know you guys are like, girl, we in February, damn near. Like, where have you been? Just, you know, getting the feel of this new year and actually preparing myself mentally and physically. And I'm happy, you know? You just have to stay prayed up and, you know, that's why we pray and we constantly thank God and, you know, just gotta live every day till it's fullest. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys about my new makeup routine. I know you guys are tired of me using the same old Fit Me Maybelline, the same old concealer, LA Girls Pro Concealer, the same old Revlon blush. I'm tired of myself too, so I definitely switched it up for you guys. And hunty, I'm looking good. I'm looking so good. So good. Please don't mind my cute little or bushy bun that I have going on here. I just like trying to get things together. So I put this face on for you guys, and this video is going to be based off all my new products, and I hope you guys find this helpful, and hopefully I explain each product down to the T so you guys can, like, if you want it, or if you got the same complexion as me or the same type of skin as me and you want to try something new, maybe you'll like some of these products and go out and get them. I'm gonna have everything linked down below. Before we get any more farther in this video, I'm gonna need you to go down and click on that subscribe button. Also hit the bell to be notified whenever I post another video, because I'm gonna be posting like crazy, okay? Posting like crazy. Don't forget to like this video, because you will like this. If you love makeup, you will like this. So I went to Sephora and I also went to Target to pick up some new things. And I told myself I had to switch up basically majority of my makeup. Some things are somewhat still the same, but some things you just can't let go, you know? Some things are like the holy grail of your makeup, and some things are just like needed to stick around. Some will be high end and some will be drugstore makeup, but as you can see, everything came together perfectly. So if you guys are feeling this look, please continue to watch this video and see how I transform into this. And thank God it turned out right. Do you see this highlight? Get in tune. Yes. Okay. Let me stop. Thank you guys for watching. Let's get right into the video. So I'm going to jump right into this video, and I'm going to show you guys my new products that I have for my new makeup routine for 2019. Here are the goodies. Alright, so first things first is primer. Well, honestly, I always moisturize and then I use primer. So a few things are still the same. I didn't switch up everything, just some things. So I'm going to moisturize my face with the L'Oreal Paris Hydra Genius. I'm so obsessed with this stuff. It's just, I apply this stuff so much in one day, it's ridiculous. So next I picked up the Maybelline Master Prime. So this is my first time using this. It's a primer and base. They say it's blur and defend, and visible blurs, skin tones, and imperfections. Smooth skin, lightweight, non-greasy formula, does not clog pores, which is really good for me. So you can also wear this under your makeup or alone. So just like if you're going to the gym or you just want to be natural that day, obviously this is a good primer. I don't like to put that much primer on my face. This smells like lotion. Like, what type of lotion does it smell like? Like regular lotion. It feels like it's putting an extra coat on your face. It feels pretty thick. It's not too thick, but it's like you're putting a good coat of lotion on your face. So far, so good. So this time, you know, usually I will have a matte primer. I'll have like the Stay Matte, but my foundation is matte and it's really matte. So I didn't want to have a matte primer and a matte foundation because I might, you know, dry my skin out. My skin is like a combination. It's like in between. It has its oily days, but it's really not that oily. So I didn't want to like overly matte my face. So for right now, we'll see how long I'm going to be able to retire Maybelline Fit Me. And I retired her for Makeup Forever, the Matte Velvet Skin Foundation. I got this in the color Y415. So this is how the package look, and this is how it comes. It's really thin. I know it probably looked like it's not a lot, like you'll probably run out this fast, but I heard that it goes a long way with just a little bit. It's 24 hours. That's why I actually was like, and also it's a matte foundation. It's so crazy that I just showed you guys the foundation. I was just so thirsty to get to the foundation that honestly, I do my eyebrows before I put my foundation on. So I went back to my holy grail, Anastasia. I'll say Anastasia, it sounds more classy. Anastasia Pomade in Ebony, my favorite. So usually I use the Pro Girls, LA Girls Pro Concealer. That's what it is. Usually I use that for my concealer. So I purchased, drum roll please, I purchased the Fenty Pro Filter Concealer, and I literally waited until this came out because I wanted to try a new concealer. I got the color 235. So I heard really good things about it. I'm going to just kind of like put it underneath my eye. And then come back with the brush to conceal underneath my eye. Y'all, I'm doing new things. This is like new for me. This is really new. I'm just going to use the remaining concealer on the brush to clean up the top. So now I'm done with that and I'm looking crazy as hell. I'm going to now blend in the concealer. I'm just going to take a little sponge and clean it up. So far, so good. I like how thick the concealer is. It doesn't feel thick, but it is thick, if that makes any sense. I don't know about y'all, but I'm eyebrows before foundation. Like, I know people that can do their whole face and then do their eyebrows last. You're a blessing. I mean, how could you? Like, how? I can't see myself. I'm actually going to try to switch it up one day and do that, but I don't think it's going to work very well for me. Okay, my brows are done, and now I can get to my favorite part. The part that I've been waiting for. The foundation. Like, you have no idea. Me and my friend Thaddeus set in Sephora for 2 hours, okay? 2 hours. For one, we were really irritated with the Sephora employee. Like, I just don't understand. Like, I know that you can't just read someone and just say, hey, they know a lot about makeup. But I purposely came into Sephora with no makeup on so I can actually find my complexion, you know what I'm saying, in different foundations. You know, they have that thing where it reads and lets you know what foundation is best for you. And the employee was like getting on my nerve, and I just had to flat out tell her, like, I am a beauty influencer. I'm just trying to, you know, find a new makeup routine for my YouTube channel. And she's like, oh, you know, but she's still just so irritated. She wasn't professional enough for me. I don't know. I think she kind of felt like we were friends. Baby, we're not friends. We're not friends. No, we're not. But I found this on my own. So I'm going to give myself this credit. I literally found this on my own. I asked her, I wanted matte, and she gave me everything else but what I wanted. But I went and I walked around and I looked at this and I'm like, maybe this would be good. And what caught my eye was the 24 hours, okay? Honey, I was sold. Some of them say 12, 14, 16 hours, but 24? How could you not? Like, so we'll see. We will see. I don't know. I have not tried it on yet. And we will see. I didn't wet my beauty blender. I have water and a plant right here, so I'm just gonna do what I do. First, I'm gonna drink some. Okay, I'm back and I have a wet beauty blender. I'm actually really liking this concealer. It's like, I'm liking it. I'm gonna apply some on my finger and so I didn't use as much and I'm like loving it. I love how matte it is. Like, it's like skin-like. Okay, so now that is done, I am truly, truly loving this. So I'm gonna come back with the Fenty Pro Filter Concealer and oh, this is so thick. I really don't need that much. Like, Rihanna did her thing. Oh my god. I think I put too much. Okay, let's not overdo it. You know when you get something new, you overdo it right off bat? Whether it's, you know, you just overdo it. That's me. I don't know if it's anybody else, but it's definitely me. Like, I overdo anything that I get new. Like, that. I didn't even have to do that. I could have dragged. Let's just continue on with this makeup look because I'm tired of myself. So I'm going to press it in and I'm going to drag it up on my nose. I really don't have much of a nose. I really don't have much of a bridge, but I'm going to drag it up to slimming my nose to make it kind of look like, you know. Concealer is like little goes a long way. So as of right now, I'm loving how matte my face is from the foundation, from the concealer. My eyebrows are popping. I am excited. My lips are really pink. I don't know what it looked like on camera. Y'all probably like, girl, you looking casket ready, but I'm not done. Okay. I just like concealed my face and yes, I know I'm looking crazy, but just wait. So now I am going to use my Satcha. I'm not gonna turn my back on this, okay? This is my favorite. So I'm just gonna use a sponge. I'm gonna put my setting powder everywhere I put my concealer. So now I'm going to warm up my face. I'm excited about this product too because I've been wanting to try it. I didn't know what color I wanted to get in this bronzer, powder bronzer, and saddle. For the ones that never seen it. So it has a little mirror. And this is the color. And I'm glad I didn't get mahogany. That's what they kept telling me I should get. But that was more of a, it had a red. It's too red. Like, I feel like it's like a brick color, you know? And I just feel like that was not going to be right. I was going to look crazy. I'm more of a natural makeup. I don't really like harsh contour or anything like that. So this is the color I got. And I'm thinking this is perfect for me. So I'm going to warm my cheeks up and we're going to see how good it is. So I'm going to warm it up with one of my BH Cosmetic brushes, my Rose Gold Collection. Okay. I think I can't really see it, honestly. I could see it, but I can't. Maybe that's the good thing. I have a little head, okay? So this is why I don't do much contouring, but I like it. Okay, so that's that. I'm going to now use this same, I'm going to get my smaller brush that I always use to contour my nose, and I'm going to use Saddle. See, as you can see, this side compared to this side is like, I'm actually creating a nose for myself because it's not really there. And I just like drag the remainder up like to my brow a little bit. And my nose, I feel like it kind of droops down. So lately I've been like, you know, kind of wanted to lift it a little bit. So I'm going to use my setting powder and kind of clean up my cheekbones. So when I do it, I just really like take it from, I always do the fish, but I kind of know it's like right from like your sideburns and you go down. Like, so it's a diagonal drag. Just diagonally just take it down, right down. So now since I'm done with that, I'm going to move on to my eyes. Today I'm going to use ColourPop. Usually I use my Carly B BH Cosmetics palette. I'm really not going to retire that palette for 2019, but just for today. So I'm going to use my ColourPop, and this is I Think I Love You. I think. So I'm going to use this palette, and I am going to use more of the neutral colors. I'm going to use this in my crease, and I'm going to use this on my lid. And then I'm going to use this in my outer crease. So just something really neutral, not too much, not too, you know, eh. If you know me, you just know I'm like simple as shit. Like, I'm just extremely simple. Like, I'm popping. It's either one or the other. I'm gonna be real, real extra, or I'm gonna be real, real simple. You can't get both. And there's no in between. So I am going to use my Morphe M535 brush for my crease. I'm going to pop the lighter eyeshadow right on my lid. This is so pigmented, like, okay, so now that I'm done with that, I am going to come back with the first color that I used for my crease, and I am going to use that to on the end of my lid. First, just so I can like warm up, since I use like a white eyeshadow, I don't want it to be to like separate it. So I'm going to use that color first, my first color. As you can see, it's just like giving that effect. I don't know, I think I kind of like this, but I'm so simple. Now I'm going to come back with my Morphe M433 brush. I'm going to do the end of my lid. And I'm really just gonna stay in one spot and just kind of pat it. And kind of drag it into my crease softly. Okay, so now that I'm done with that, I am going to come back with the brush that I use on my crease. And I am just going to buff out the darker color. So it won't be no lines. All right, so now that I'm done with that, I am now going to take off the sachet. I'm going to use Maybelline Curvitude Liner in black. I decided to get this because it has a curve in it, and I always have a problem with like going over my lash. I don't know why, but I'm like, maybe this will work. Maybe. This is how it looks out of the packaging. It's pretty cool. I'm just going to do a simple line straight across. I'm not going to do a wing liner or anything. It glides on so smooth, like so far so good. I have not disliked anything that I've used at all. So one thing I did forget to get was mascara, because I really didn't think I need mascara, because I already had mascara and I still like my mascara. Like I did say, I'm not switching up every single thing. I actually forgot to get mascara, not gonna lie. So yeah, I'm going to use my L'Oreal Volumis mascara. And I love to like go at the top of my lashes because it make them like really tacky and wet, because once you put your lashes on and you like press down, it makes your lashes, it makes the lash stick to your lashes better, in my opinion. So I'm going to apply my lashes. So now that I have my lashes on, aren't they so pretty? These lashes are mine. I won't say the name of them, but I will be selling them very soon, and I will be letting you guys know more information towards February. I might be dropping February 1st. Who knows? Who knows? I don't know. But these are my favorite. They are so beautiful. Like, look at them. Oh my God. Since I'm done with the lashes, I'm going to do my bottom lash. Okay, so since I finished my bottom lash, I am now going to move on to my lips. I'm still going to do the same lip that I always do, my neutral lip, my natural lip. I can't get rid of it, like that's my favorite. I just use a regular brown, light brown, medium brown lip liner from the beauty supply store. And I just outline my lips. I'm too lazy to get up and go get my chapstick. It's in my purse, and my purse is all the way over there, and I'm not getting up to go get it. So I'm just gonna lick my lips a little. Don't judge me. So I am now going to use, I think they changed the packaging on this. They did, because this wasn't the same packaging at all. But this is the Revlon Photo Ready Concealer. So I didn't get the right one. I don't think I got the right one. I think I got light. I think I was supposed to get medium beige. Is this the medium beige one? This is the light one. But we're gonna make it do what it do. So I'm not gonna apply that much. I just put it right in the middle of my lip. And I get this because it's shaped like lipstick. Like, even though, and it like goes up, and look how much it gives you. Like, well,
I guess that's not really a lot, but me using it for my lip, it is. And all these things are not at Sephora. The things that like are like Revlon and Maybelline, they're from Target. I just apply that on my lip. And then I come back with my holy grail. This is Revlon lip gloss. I love this. I love this. I love it so much. This is the Sky Pink 207. So I'm just gonna, if I could twist it off, I'm just gonna pop this right on my lip. And you're just gonna see how it just glides on. It makes my lips look so good. So I always try to stay away from putting my brush onto the brown liner. And I just kind of rub it in. I have a lip brush that I use as well. And I just make sure that the brown liner isn't too harsh by blending it in. Oh, I love my natural lip. I love it. Oh my God. This is like the best lip combo ever that you will ever get. Ever. So now I'm going to use Revlon, the powder blush that I just got, and it's in the number 4. Alright, so it's matte as well, so I'm just matting it out. It's going to be dry as hell, but I'm going to be cute as hell. So now I'm just going to use my blush brush. So I just apply the blush right on top of my contour. Right on top of the bronzer. I never like harsh blush. I don't care for anything that's too harsh. So now what I'm going to use to highlight my face. I look so pretty right now. I'm so happy. I'm so excited. Maybelline Master Chrome and the Molten Gold. Like, I can't get away from this. This is stuck with me forever. Like, we're inseparable. Like, where am I going? Where will I go to? This just looks so good on my skin. So I'm going to use a smaller brush. I usually use a thicker brush, but I'm going to use a smaller brush that I've been using lately for my highlight. And I'm going to just, I hate when I have to mess up the lines in makeup. Girl, I'll be hitting the pan on this, okay? The pan. See, do you see that? Now, y'all didn't see that glow at first. I'm looking, that's crazy. This is a drugstore highlighter. Like, you can't get no better than this. Oh my God, look at that highlight. That's crazy. I'm saying, oh my God, like this is my first time actually using this. That's just how good it is. Okay, so I'm done with highlighting my face. And now this is the finishing. So now that I'm complete with the look, I am now going to use my Too Faced Peach Mist. So I heard nothing but good things about this. Yeah. And I got it in the travel size because I'm always going somewhere. And it's really no point for me to get the bigger if I'm always traveling. And then I'll be mad that I didn't. So it's like a waste of money to get the bigger one. And then, yeah. So I got the smaller one. Oh, that's cute. I like stuff like this. You ever had like a nail polish where you shake it and you hear the balls in it? This is very satisfying right now. Okay, so this is how the bottle looks. Oh, it says shake me, baby.
You gotta tell me what.
So, it says shake well. Well, I definitely did that. And yeah, now hold it. Oh, it's all cute and stuff. So I'm just gonna miss my face. Oh, you really don't need nothing but three sprays, because for one, the mist is like, and it smells really good too. Oh, okay. So yeah, it tastes like, it smells like peach and cream. Yeah, I'm likey. I likey likey. And that is it. This is the finishing look. I am so satisfied. I am proud of myself because I really hate going makeup shopping, and I did an amazing job. Like, I went to Target today and I'm like, look, I'm here for this that, and I literally went in there and got this that. I went to Sephora yesterday and today, back and forth. Like, I didn't spend that long in Sephora this time because I knew exactly what I wanted, and everything I got I'm proud of. From the foundation and the concealer, I matched those off myself. I'm proud of myself because I was actually scared I was gonna get on camera and it was gonna look totally different. My face looks so good right now. Like, oh my God, I'm back. Like, I'm back. Like, it's 2019. This is it. It's just as matte as I want it to be. I'm so pleased. So everything that I used today, other than the products that I've named that I've used before in my previous videos, this was my first time trying it, so I'm just as pleased as all of you guys. Let me know if you guys have any questions. Let me know if you guys ever use one of these products, you know. And now at this point, we're twinsing, or go buy them so then we can really be twinsing. I'm happy. Now I need somewhere to go. So, ciao. See you guys later. I'm gonna go find me some business. Thank you guys for watching.